Hello and welcome back. In our previous video, we introduced ECT, electric circuit theory, as a language, and I promised it has very few words in its vocabulary. Today we begin to build up that vocabulary, and we begin with three words you've heard before: charge, current, and voltage. Those words you've seen in physics courses in first year or in high school. Here we will look at them from a different perspective. The view of an engineer. We need to gain some intuitive feel and a deeper understanding for what they are to be successful in electrical engineering. Let's begin with the first one, charge. That is a concept that began in physics with a much longer name. It used to be quantity of electricity or quantity of electric charge. For a long time, we've dropped the word quantity. So in physics, we call that electric charge. But in electrical engineering, electric is kind of a redundant adjective. So we call that simply charge. And we measure that in coulombs. But the question remains, what is this charge? Well, you see, in this part of the multiverse where you and I believe we exist, materials have two observable properties. One of them is mass and the other is charge. Nobody really knows what they really are, but we know out of measurements how to predict the behavior of materials given those assumptions of existence of mass and electricity, of charge, if you will. Mass we represent with the letter M. We measure that in kilograms, in pounds, in slugs, etc. An electric charge, we measure that in coulombs, and we represent that unit with an uppercase C. By the way, even though we dropped the word quantity from its name, we continue to use Q to represent that parameter. So we say charge Q is so many coulombs, uppercase C. Charge comes in two varieties, positive charge, negative charge. The smallest amount of electricity in this universe is that of the electron in its negative type, or the proton in its positive one. Let's not talk about positrons, please. And that is a quantity of electricity so small it is 1.60 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulombs. It is so tiny that to have one coulomb, we would need 6.24 billions of billions of electrons. Get a load of that. 6 billions of billions of electrons only to add up to one coulomb of charge. So if you think of that, the particles of electricity, namely electrons, are so tiny and so abundant, they are indeed much smaller and abundant than the molecules of any liquid in this universe, water, for instance. So that it's not too far-fetched to think of electricity as a fluid, and it's something we shall do. We think of electricity as a fluid that permeates electric systems. That metaphor is particularly appropriate when we're describing electric phenomena in metals. Why is that? Because in metals, electrons swarm about freely in huge numbers, ready to be pushed this way or that way by an externally applied electric field, which is something that you and I shall do. Let's summarize then. We have charge Q in coulombs and represent that with an uppercase C. By the way, the name of the unit is to honor the French physicist of the 18th century, Charles Augustin Coulomb, who gave us the law that has his name that predicts the electrostatic forces among a distribution of electric charges. Let's move our attention now to the second word of this lecture, current. This concept also had a much longer name. It used to be intensity of electric courage. In the days when everything was intensity, intensity of the gravitational field, intensity of the electric field, intensity of the magnetic field, intensity, intensity, intensity. Not anymore. We don't call that intensity of electric current. We still represent it with the letter I, but we dropped intensity. So electric current among physicists, and guess what? Among electrical engineers, just current, current I. But what is current? Well, let me tell you, current is electricity in motion. That's what it is. When somehow we convince electricity to flow in a direction that we want, we have established a current. Now the point is, how do we measure that current? Let me give you an example. Assume that in this cable that you see here, we have some flow of electricity, and it's flowing towards my right, your left. And we want to know how strong, how much of a current we have there. We want to know how quickly electricity is flowing through this cable. You know what we do? We cut it here and we insert a device in there. We set a checkpoint, this device. That is an ammeter. That is a counter of electric charge that will tell us how many coulombs are crossing that point, flowing to the right every second. And it reads 3 coulombs per second are flowing to the right. That is the value of the current. So many coulombs per second flowing to the right. So current high has a value, 3 in this case, a unit coulombs per second. And it has a direction to the right, to the left, this way, that way. Without the 3, that current is not completely specified. Coulombs per second is a unit we use so often that we shorten that to a single unit. Instead of using coulombs per second, we call coulombs per second ampere or amp. Represent that with an uppercase. Je sais mes amis de la France et du Québec que c'est un homme que nous prononçons ampère. But here in America, we call that ampere or very often just amp. We represent that still with an uppercase A and we symbolize with the letter I. So far, we have seen 2 word concepts, charge Q in coulombs, uppercase C, and current I in amperes or amps in an uppercase A used to represent it. Let's move on to the 3rd word concept, that is voltage. For the 3rd time, this word concept used to be much longer among physicists. It used to be electric potential difference, 3 words. And it's measured in volts and represented with the letter V. Well, electrical engineers use this value so often, this electric potential difference, that we decided to call that by the units. It's measured in volts. We call that voltage. And in some fields of electrical engineering, that electric power, sometimes we call that tension, but hardly ever we call that electric potential difference. Voltage it is, represented by a V and measured in volts. The unit symbol, an uppercase V. The name of the unit is there to honor that Italian physicist and inventor who bequeathed us the electric battery, Alessandro Volta. His full name was a bit longer than that. It was, let me read this, Alessandro Giuseppe Antonio Anastasio Gerolamo Umberto Volta. That was his name. In this course, we will look at voltage from a different perspective. We will consider that an electric height sometimes, and some other times, an electric pressure. We'll say things like, the charge is dropping through this device because the electric height drop across that is of so many volts, 3 volts, 5 volts, 7 volts, 100 volts. Or some other times we say this battery supplying an electric pressure of 15 volts, of 12 volts, 120 volts, whatever. Let me justify this metaphor.